May I come in, sir?
Come in.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon. Have your seat, Ajit.
Thank you, sir.
Ajit, I think you could have noticed that we are following all the COVID protocols.
Yes.
Maintaining sufficient distance so as to let you feel safe. And we are using mask when not speaking and removing it only when we have to speak.
Yes.
You have also got the two choices. If you want to remove your mask, you can. Otherwise, you can continue with mask also. Which way you like to do?
Sir, I want to remove.
Remove it. Remove it.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Introduce yourself in a manner that your caste and community is not indicated.
Yes. Sir, my name is Ajit Kumar. I come from Munger, Bihar. I have done my graduation in industrial engineering from IIT Kharagpur. And my hobby is playing badminton.
Okay. So, what are you doing?
Sir, currently I am preparing for civil services.
So, after doing your BTEC from Kharagpur IIT, such a prestigious institution, you couldn't get a job.
Sir, I got the job, but I did not join it. I started preparing for civil services.
Right away in 2015, you started preparing?
Yes.
For last 5 years, you are preparing for this job?
Yes, sir. Yes.
And you are now appearing in BPSC also?
Yes, sir.
Why? Industrial engineering is not a good field?
Sir, it is a good field, but my interest lies in civil services, so I came in this.
When did you discover that interest lies in civil services?
Sir, in the last semester of my college, when I started thinking what to do next, so I thought of civil services and then only I decided to pursue it.
Okay. So, what prompted you to opt economics as an optional?
Sir, because industrial engineering was not a subject offered as an optional, and as an elective subject, I have taken few portion of economics, and that is why I was inclined towards this subject.
Okay. Let's see. Monopolistic competition is such a organizational form of companies that consumers are exploited through deceitful advertisements and deceitful display of goods. And this is growing more and more in India today. How to guard the interest of consumers?
Sir, government has recently passed the Consumer Protection Act of 2019. That has the various guidelines to safeguard the interest of consumer. That was one of the improvement done in this regard. And apart from this, sir, we can also have civil suits as well as consumer court suits if there is a false advertisement done of the product. And I think, sir, one more thing can be added in this is that the role models which are doing advertisement, they should also have some responsibility and of the fake advertisement that they are doing.
Do you think that in India today in telecommunication market, there is duopoly?
Sir, largely it is duopoly.
So, what kind of decision making is found in duopoly? How decisions are taken?
Sir, there are two firms, and the one firm changes its decision, and according to that, the second firm also optimizes its decision. So, they are in a kind of a price competition as well as the methods to grab more and more market. So, predatory pricing is also one of the consequences of duopoly.
Predatory pricing is legally allowed or it's a prohibited practice?
Sir, it's a prohibited practice, but some kind of price competition can be there. Competition Commission of India is there to look into this aspect of predatory pricing.
Do you think TRAI has been successful in maintaining fair and competitive environment in telecommunication market?
Sir, largely it has been successful, but in the recent years, the telecom sector has converted into duopoly, which I think more and more competitors should be here to enhance the quality of telecommunication services.
Why public sector companies like BSNL and MTNL are losing their market fast?
Sir, there are a lot of reasons behind that. One is the inefficiency in the public sector like BSNL and MTNL because of the high employees cost and their lack of adaptability in terms of technology as well as infrastructure is leading to lose the market to the other two players like Airtel and Jio.
It is said that corporate governance in India is problematic. In this background, corporatization of governance is ethically allowed process or we should discourage it? That is, private companies are not having ethical practices within their own organization. They're resorting to many unethical practices. And the government wants to corporatize their decision-making process. So entire governance would become also unethical.
Sir, it is not like that all corporates are unethical. So there are few corporates that are doing unethical things. But largely, corporate also follows the ethical guidelines. And these practices should be enhanced.
So why then the farmers are having such a deep-rooted distrust against private companies with respect to contract farming?
There might be few cases that has not yielded good results for the farmer in terms of contract farming, and that is why they are resorting to this change. But I think if we can have a good regulation in contract farming, then it would be profitable for both farmer as well as corporate sector, and agriculture sector will also boom up.
So do you think good regulation is missing till today?
Yes, sir. In agriculture, I think good regulation can come.
Thank you, Ajit.
Okay, Ajit. These days, intercaste marriages are a commonplace, no? Still, can you please tell me one scheme sponsored by the government of Bihar to, you know, encourage such practices, intercaste marriages?
Sorry, sir, I have to look.
You are not aware. You are from Munger, right?
Yes.
Munger is, infamous for, this illegal manufacturing of weapons.
Yes.
Is it so?
Yes, sir, it is infamous.
Do you also concur with my viewpoint that the district administration, especially the police administration, is in hand in glove with, such people who are indulging into this illegal practice?
Sir, not all section of police, but yes, there are few people from police that are hand in hand with some of the illegal manufacturer of guns, and that is why they are still present.
So if Ajit becomes part of that police system, will be still saying ki Munger is infamous for manufacturing of illegal weapons?
Pardon, sir, I didn't know.
If you become part of police system, will be still saying or discussing, debating that Munger today is still infamous for, abetting manufacturing of illegal weapons? Or will there be any change?
Sir, definitely I would like to
What will be your plan of action? How will you curb this menace?
Few steps can be taken. First is there was already the private manufacturer present in the Munger, but the production has gone down in the private sector. And because of the stringent rules and regulation, they are not getting license.
Now I'm talking about the manufacturing of Katta, to be very specific.
Sir, for that only, we need to corporatize those skilled laborers into the private manufacturers, so that they can get job in the private sector and they work under regulation, and this illegal manufacturing will go away. This is one of the method. Secondly, sir, reskilling of workers can be done. Those who are having skill for gun manufacturing can be incorporated in some other sectors by reskilling them.
Okay. So my understanding of your reply is, if these two sets of suggestions are put in practice, definitely this Munger will get itself, a big relief from this illegal activities, right?
And sir, third is the law and order enforcement.
Fine. Did you ever bother, even for once, that you should, apprise about these set of suggestions to the district administration? Did you ever thought of this, or do you today repent? I should have done that. I didn't do my bounden duty as a citizen of India, especially coming from Bihar, coming from Munger.
Sir, there are already works going in that direction. District administration of Munger currently is targeting those sections.
Now you are shifting the goalpost. So you didn't that.
Yes, sir, I didn't do that.
You confess that it is a mistake on your part.
Yes, sir, I confess.
Okay, fine. Tell me, Uttar Pradesh, we have recently, commissionerate system. We have shifted from the dual, administrative system to commissionerate system, fine, especially in Lucknow and Noida. Which district of Bihar, qualifies to be, upgraded under this commissionerate system if Bihar desires to experiment with this, and what will be the advantage?
Sir, I think first and foremost, the capital city of Bihar, Patna, needs to have a commissionerate system, and apart from that, Gaya and Bhagalpur.
So what will be the advantage?
Sir, advantage is that there would be direct control of police and police authority over the districts. Now law and order in general system, like currently in Patna, the district magistrate had the in charge of law and district magistrate is being the in charge of law and order, and it has to coordinate with the
so there will be crystallized chain of command, right?
Yes.
My last question to you: do you know something about this Atmanirbhar Bharat Rojgar Yojana?
Yes, sir. Yes.
What is that? Can you please share with me the fine points of this Yojana?
Sir, this Atmanirbhar Bharat Rojgar Yojana has been launched in 6 states where migrant laborers has mostly come, and Bihar is one of them. And they are targeting some skill based.
No, it is not. That the Yojana that you are referring to is Garib Kalyan Rojgar Yojana. I'm asking Atmanirbhar Bharat Rojgar Yojana. It has something to do with EPFO. It has something to do with subsidy scheme to be given to a particular organization which is registered with EPFO and having less than 1,000 workers. So government will be providing subsidy in terms of this GPF contribution. Sir, please.
Yes, Ajit. Ajit, you comes from the Munger.
Yes.
So I believe so. You are well versed with the geography of the Bihar.
Yes, sir.
And the adjoining district of your district.
Yes, yes.
So which districts share the boundary with your district?
One is Lakhisarai.
Mm.
Second is Banka.
Mm.
Third is Khagaria on the north side, and fourth is Bhagalpur.
Only four.
There are others also, sir.
Some are missing.
Some are missing.
ठीक है, no problem. Tell me, Ajit, suppose what is your preference in your services, job preferences?
Sir, first is Bihar Administrative Services.
Mm.
Second is Bihar Police Services.
Bihar Police Services.
And third is Bihar Financial Services.
So, Ajit, tell me, if you succeed as a DSP.
Yes, sir.
For example, and there is a case, hypothetically, which comes like under your supervision. Something like, which also have an impact of National Honor Act 1971. Why? Because of some a kid of, the 10 years old. A kid having the age of the 10 years old. Somehow he has disregarded or you can say discredited an act of, dishonoring of national flag. Police people, police personnel, they confine to the chap, boy, also the mother of the kid. How you deal with this?
Sir, because boy is minor, under 18 year of age, I think the most suitable step for me would be to warn that boy and also to warn the parents of that boy so that they respect the national flag in future and not to repeat the act. Sir, I think warning would be the first step.
You would firstly, give the warning that, this particular act should not be repeated.
Yes.
But act has been done.
For that, sir, I think there are juvenile centers in which that child can be sent for reforms.
What about the mother?
Sir, I think...
However, she is not a culprit. But the police has also, taken her.
I think mother should be left after proper warning so that their child don't repeat this.
There is another situation which is happening recently and we are witnessing also. That state legislatures, they are somehow not following the summons given by Supreme Court. Maharashtra Legislative Assembly has, come up with this kind of the resolution recently.
Yes.
Do you think there is a tussle, possible tussle which might occur between the judiciary and the legislature? Are they infringing their rights? Each of the institutions are infringing, the rights within the ambit of the constitution.
Sir, first of all, this is one of the occasional incident which has happened in the recent parts. And I think...
Has it happened in the previous also? Previously also? Any this kind of act has been happened?
With judiciary, sir, I'm not able to recall it.
Okay.
But there are center state issues.
Do you find any constitutional emergency where the judiciary and the legislative assemblies, they might be, locking their horns?
Sir, this is one of the case that privilege on which that legislative assembly is saying that they have a right on the code of privilege issue.
So both parties are rightly exercising their, authorities.
Sir, I think judiciary has the final say in code of privilege also, because at the end, it is the matter of if somebody is punishing.
But the privilege has also been assigned in the constitution to the members of the legislative assemblies.
Yes, sir. I agree. But there is a judicial review that is given by constitution, and the final.
In this light, what does say the basic structure of the constitution?
Separation of power.
So it should be respected?
Yes, sir. It should be respected. But I think again.
Fine. My last question to you. Automated facial recognition technology.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Is anti-democracy.
Sir,
with the recent developments which occurred worldwide, not only in India.
Sir, with the increase in technology, there is a increase in terrorism activities also. The terrorists are using very sophisticated technology.
Terrorists do not come in the masses.
Pardon, sir?
Terrorists do not come in masses or in bulk.
Yes, sir.
On the road.
Yes, sir. I agree. But for securing the state and nation, the country has to upgrade its technology in terms of security. And that is why the facial recognition technology has come up.
It would dilute the spirit of protest at the same time. It would dilute the spirit of the protest or the dissent among the people against the verdict of the government or the state. Don't you think so?
Pardon? Sorry, sir. I think that it can help in securing the nation, but there should be proper guideline and regulation to use this technology so that misuse of this technology does not take place.
Okay, sir.
Ajit, badminton is your hobby.
Yes, sir.
Can you tell us who won the BWF World Championship gold medal last year?
Sorry, sir. I'm not able to recall the name. I will look into it.
Male or female, either?
Sir, it is Kinto Momota in male, and in female world championship, Nozomi Okuhara, I think, from Japan has won.
And not PV Sandhu?
Sorry, sir, I'm not able to recall it.
And who won bronze in male segment?
Sorry, sir, I have to look into that.
Who was awarded Arjun Award last year?
Sir, I'm not sure, but it is Pranay was nominated.
In which country badminton as a game emerged?
Sir, the modern form of badminton emerged in British India, and the Britain was the first nation to evolve this game as a modern badminton.
Any place in British India which is credited for badminton?
Gloucestershire.
British India you are talking, India.
In Britain it was Gloucestershire, and in British India it was Pune.
Okay. Nice talking to you, Ajit. Your interview is over. You may go now.
Thank you, sir. Thanks.
Ajit, have your seat.
Thank you, sir.
So, how far do you feel prepared?
I need to prepare a lot. I am not prepared much.
Date of interview is 4th January, no?
Yes, yes.
You will have 10, 15 days.
Yes, yes.
And are you sitting this PT also?
Yes, sir. I am going home, and my center is in hometown only. So,
have you identified areas where you need to specifically work to improve?
Sir, first is in hobby and badminton, I need to study more. I was not prepared at all.
Okay. Fine. See, you are a good candidate, Ajit. And you are having a strong claim to succeed finally. Our assessment is that you are prepared. Of course, you have noticed that your badminton part is not ready. So, invest a couple of days.
Yes.
To get ready there. And also look at some names from Bihar.
Yes, it is.
Badminton players of Bihar, Jharkhand also, kind of things. Rest of the things are good. That means your range of knowledge is good. Your articulation is good. Your sitting posture is good. This tie a little is more shiny.
I will change it, sir.
So, you need to have position, that is sitting posture is good, your facial expression is good, you are having a smiling face, and you have good flow because you have got clarity of thought, so you are having displaying it in your flow also. So all these things are fine. That means there is a, apart from that hobby part, there is no major interventions required.
Yes, yes.
Okay, so just keep it up and correct it and go with good confidence. Best of luck.
Thank you, sir.